Hello, this is Dr. Jeon In-seong from Dental Bean. Today's patient is a 35-year-old female. The area we will be operating on today is the number 26 and number 27. Let's briefly review the patient's previous images. I previously completed the procedure on tooth number 17 for this patient. You can observe a typical example of pneumatization. Before extracting number 6 and 7, the sinus cavity was significantly enlarged. Now, it's been over a year and a half since the extraction. If we look at the images taken before today's surgery, you can see that pneumatization has fully occurred. However, the remaining alveolar bone height is only about 2 to 3 millimeters, and there is also a septum present. Therefore, we are planning a lateral approach with sinus lift and immediate implantation. For today's surgery, we will be using Core 1 implant form CyberMed.
Thank you.
my observation after the surgery. The anterior implant is a OO 4.5 by 8.5 mm core 1 implant, and the posterior one is a OO 5.0 by 10 mm core 1 implant. For the bone graft, we use xenograft material from osteo.in, specifically InnoSSB. Due to septum in the middle, I had to slightly expand the window anterior from its original position, but I was able to successfully elevate the sinus in the anterior region as well. The surgery was completed successfully without any perforation of the mucosa. Let's take a quick look at the postoperative CT scans for this patient. In the preoperative CT, this is the number 26 region before surgery. Next, you can see the postoperative view of number 26, where the bone graft has integrated well. This is the preoperative view of the number 27, and this is the postoperative view. The sinus lift procedure was completed as planned. In any case, we will need to wait approximately 6 months in this state. Since the remaining alveolar bone is quite thin, in cases like this, I will provide further updates after 6 months, once the final prosthesis has been placed.